This is DC Channel Guns. Like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.
Isolation, pain, and firearms. Recent studies showing firearm suicide among elderly grew almost 50% from 2010 to 2018.
The older people have been more isolated, have delayed their mental health or physical health care, and they still continue to live with guns at home. Almost 1 in 4 older people have guns at home.
Now, with the pandemic, Dr. Jagdish Gupchandani, public health professor at NMSU, suggests these numbers will climb.
What up? This is DC Channel Guns coming at you another gun video. Appreciate you watching, like, sharing, and subscribe. So I want to appreciate all my subscribers. I want to appreciate y'all for coming over here. I appreciate the new people in the 2A community. We're going to need in the long run. Support your 2A channels, people, your gun channels. We need all the help we can. Also, a huge shout out to y'all that come over here and smash the like button. And another shout out to y'all that come over here every single day through the good and the bad and the ups and downs. Nothing moves in a straight line, people. So with that said, I want to go over something quickly, put this on your radar, people. You probably never heard of this. Some of you might have, some of you, this is some of the stuff I've been looking at, and I want to share this with y'all. I was looking at some stuff, and they've been talking about firearm retirement. And I was like, firearm retirement? What is they talking about? So they're saying that, you know, seniors and elderly people, you know, people who's getting up in age and everything, they're saying that, you know, some of the elderly and stuff need to be retired from firearms and stuff. Now, this comes from one of these research centers and stuff that doing research on seniors and firearms and all this kind of stuff. When it comes to firearms, they're doing everything they possibly can to get firearms out of your hands, people. So they're targeted seniors and the elderly and stuff when it comes to firearms. They need to protect themselves too. Now, I talked about this when it comes to the red flag laws, that it was targeting a lot of the elderly people, seniors and stuff. I did a lot of videos on that. It was a lot of elderly and stuff where they use the red flag law abuse on some of the seniors and stuff, where the family, you know, had the police go out to the, you know, the family member house, an elderly person, and take their firearms and collections and stuff like that. So they've been subject to the red flag laws abuse that elderly and stuff have. And right now, here we go with this article that, you know, firearm retirement for the seniors and stuff. Now, this group said that they done a lot of research on this, and they're saying that it is an important issue given that 40% of old Americans living at home with a gun. They're basically saying that a large amount of them pretty much will develop dementia or major depression, and they're having easy access to a firearm, and that's possible they can harm themselves accidentally or intentionally. So this is what they're saying with older people with firearms and stuff like that. Now, I know a lot of older people who got firearms and everything. You know, they can handle the gun just as well as a lot of these younger people out here handling firearms and stuff like that. And so, you know, with that said, people, see, these gun laws and stuff, and they're targeting the elderly and stuff like that. And that's what they've been doing with the red flag laws, targeting the elderly. So here we go with this research. I'm like, you know, they say that, you know, because you got certain elderly people, you know, you got to take the keys from them because they're driving and stuff like that. Then they're saying that some of them, you got to take the firearms and stuff from them. There's a lot of elderly and stuff that I know who stays alone and stuff, and they need some protections too. I'm talking about they have, you know, far as dementia and stuff like that. I guess that's a case by case basis. I don't know how bad that person is and everything, but you know, I just know that elderly are subject to a whole lot of robberies and home invasions and stuff like that. They're already subject to a lot of these scams and stuff that is going around and stuff. People calling them on the phone and stuff like that. But, you know, they're going to take advantage of any little possible gap they can to pretty much confiscate firearms, people. This administration here is using everything. They're using research centers. They're using polls. I'm seeing all this stuff. And what they're doing, they're basically trying to convince people, hey, you know, this is what we need to do and stuff like that. And so now they're doing this using research saying, hey, at a certain point, you know, when it comes to elderly and stuff, you need to confiscate their guns. And one thing I've been talking about, the Biden administration are using the health department, people. They're using the health department and they're focused on mental health and all this kind of stuff. And, you know, when they say they want to strengthen the background check, enhance it, people, Trust me, when they're talking about enhancing, I've been looking at so much information. I know a lot of y'all know a lot of this, but they want to use a lot of these little things to bar you from getting a firearm. If they're saying, oh, well, you know, if you got elderly people getting dementia, stuff like that, this right here will stop them from getting a firearm. They want to use everything, and they want to use your health condition. They want to use the pills that you're taking, the medication. This is some of the stuff that they, right now, people, when I go to renew my CCW and stuff like that, I got to release hospital records and all this kind of stuff. And, you know, right now they're really focused on mental health because, you know, they're wanting to use your records, you know, any medication, all this kind of stuff against you. And especially when it comes to the elderly, if they're taking depression medicine or all this kind of stuff, it will bar them from having a firearm. And also, I'm seeing states that are increasing you know, the red flag laws and stuff like that. This is another way that they can go confiscate firearms. This would give them, you know, some type of motive. So, we got to go take the firearm because, hey, they're taking medicine for depression or they just developed dementia and all this kind of stuff. So they're looking at every little percentage they can to confiscate guns, people in this country. So I kind of want to put that on your radar and everything about when it comes to firearm retirement and stuff like that. Now, like I said before, I did an article a while back where the older people has been targeted with the red flag laws. I think I did an article on a guy who he had a gun shop and he had, you know, a gun collection and stuff. And the family was worried about him. And next thing you know, they had the police go out to the family member house and they confiscated all this old stuff that he had, his collection stuff. And the guy did nothing. And then they said, oh, he can go petition in court to get his stuff back. And they know he couldn't go to court petition to get his stuff back because he didn't really have the money to try to get a lawyer. And you got to pay for own, you know, your own lawyer and all this kind of stuff. And I think the guy ended up losing all this stuff and everything because they were saying, you know, he don't need to be having all this stuff. And so this is something that we need to keep an eye on stuff on. They want to target the seniors and stuff when it comes to protecting yourself. So I believe that seniors should be able to protect themselves, just like I know a lot of people 85, 90 still out here driving. So with that said, people, I just want to put that on your radar. This is D-Channel Guns, and I catch you on the next one.
This is DC Channel Guns. Like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.